Good morning, YouTube. About 5 years ago, I had converted these old T12 fluorescent fixtures over to LED T8 tubes, and I made a couple of videos on that conversion process. I did do the frosted glass coating because these were unfrosted bulbs, so I used some of this Rust-Oleum frosted glass paint on the clear tubes. None of the frosted coating has degraded, it hasn't yellowed, it hasn't chipped off. I've had several comments from viewers of that video in that I didn't show all the steps that I did in converting these fixtures. And I've had a couple of other related comments. Let me turn off these lights and I'll unplug this one from the wall so we can work on it here. Yeah, they've got the power off there, and one of the questions I had was, did I do anything to these T12 tombstones? And the answer is no. That's the original tombstone that came with the old T12 lights. And these are T8 tubes, and they just fit right in. It's the same bi-pin spacing that you get on the T12 and the T8s. They're the same. And you can see how the frosted glass coating is still on there. I have 10 of these tubes and I haven't had any failures over the last 5 years. They've been running just fine. I labeled these that the ballast has been bypassed for LED type B tubes, but a type B tube has live at one end and then neutral at the other end. The reason I did these in place is I didn't want to take them down. The power wires are fed through the ceiling rafters there. It would probably double the amount of work to take these things down to work on them on the ground. So I did this work up on a ladder, and I can work with one hand and hold on to the ladder with the other hand. And with my third hand, if I had one, I would hold the camera, but I couldn't safely work on the wires and hold the camera and hold on to the ladder to be safe at the same time, and I didn't have anybody to help me film this. So that's why I didn't show cutting and, you know, wire nutting the wires together, but I'll go through the motions and show you what I did. Okay, there I have removed the reflector, and I used a nut driver to remove the hex head screws that went into both ends. Here's the original magnetic ballast that was in there. These two yellow wires came out of here, and I took this black wire that comes out of the power cord. So here's your live. I took the black, the two yellows, so the two yellows run down there. And then there's a pair of black jumper wires. The old fluorescent tubes were the same way. So you can see the yellow wires used to run over here, and they came out of here. So I went snip, and I took the other yellow wire and snipped it. And then I took a wire stripper and went onto the wire and stripped off a little bit of insulation. And then I took one of the existing wire nuts that was in the fixture already on the black wire, and I just took the black wire and the two yellow wires and stuck them together. Let's see, I guess on this end, the original wires, they had two reds to this side, two blues to this side, and those came out here. Cut those four wires. So here's the incoming power cable, and the white wire comes back here. And there's the original wire nut with the two blues, two reds, and the white. And that connects both tombstones on that end together. And again, it's a type B tube, so this end is neutral. The other end is hot. And then here's the original ground connection. I just left that in place. So one note on this conversion process, I'm not sure if these wire colors are standard, so what you would need to really do is consult the little wiring diagram on your ballast to see how the wires are connected. So you can see here I had black white, that's these two wires, and that's your incoming power, It says line, and then there's yellow goes to one end of the tube, and that was these two wires. And then over here it has red, red, blue, blue. There's your four wires that go to the other end of the tube. So don't go by these wire colors on my ballast. Look at your light. Yeah, so there should be probably two or four wires going to one end of the fixture and two or four wires going to the other end of the fixture, and then two more wires hooked to the incoming power. So originally the incoming hot went to this wire that went into the ballast. So I just took the wire nut off that wire and put it onto these wires. And then likewise, there was the original neutral that went to the ballast. I disconnected that and connected it over there. And the ballast is just sitting here. It's not doing anything. Yeah, so I actually had left the ballast in place. Okay, and so yeah, I was able to actually remove the ballast. It's clipped in on that end, and then it's got a fixed stud here. I thought that was a loose screw, so I never tried to remove it. Just to kind of clean it up, I took a cable clamp there and was able to use the stud to hold those wires in place. If having the ballast in there bothers you, you can take it out. So maybe people were confused because the ballast was still in there. I just left it in there because it was an extra step. Okay, we've got the reflector back in, all the wires tucked inside. So let me put the tubes in and show you that it still works. Okay, there we go. Lights still work. The ballast is gone. So inside there is just wires. Hopefully that helps clear up the conversion process. If you have any other questions, post up in the comment section down below. I'll put the original video links over on the left side and in the video description. And as always, thanks for watching.